Hey hackers, are you not getting enough bounties? Are your recon too slow? You come to the right place. Today we are exploring AXIOM, the favorite tool to speed up initial bug bounty process. Let's change the way you initially approach the target by employing this amazing tool. This video we are going to overview its unique place in the Infosec industry. Check the top features, explore the initial steps of Recon. Also, I have a blog post how you can set it up, so feel free to find the link down below in the description. It's a pretty unique article, so feel free to check it out. But in this video, I'm going to show the core of this tool and show how you can use it to maximize your bounties. So stay to the end, since as a bonus, I will show you how you can stand out from the crowd by building custom module. So explore our favorite go-to place when exchanging the cybersecurity information, the Twitter. As you can see, if I use these search terms, AXIOM Recon, you won't get as many results as you want. And those results are pretty outdated. Well, this thing is pretty useful still nowadays, but it's pretty old. And I think it's only me I'm sharing just a little bit about this topic. As you can see, I have 5 articles already covering much in detail how you can start using this tool. Of course, feel free to check the wiki page of it, since it also have pretty nice guide how you can quick start it, like basic commands and stuff like that. But as you can see here on Twitter, not many people like to talk about it, since if you are using this tool, you will get unfair advantage against other testers while like on the recon process. And maybe another second reason why not a lot of people are sharing this, it's because if in the wrong hands, this tool could cause a harm, and you can make big mistakes and create a lot of destruction. Like, for example, if you have like 20 servers and you're hacking on one target, it could feel like DDoS attack, and the cloud provider will probably ban you, and also you could get in trouble. So make sure you are using this tool correctly. Before even going to the terminal and checking my methodology, what I suggest you to do is save this wiki page, especially the quick start guide, as the bookmark in your browser. It will be pretty useful when you forget, for example, how to run specific command, don't know what to do. It's good thing to have, so because they have like basic coverage of main commands. For example, AXIOM ls list your instances. You can specify instance and connect to it using connect or SSH, make a backup out of it, and of course after job is done you want to remove them as well. And yeah, this quick start guide is pretty awesome. And as well, scan section, you should pay a lot of attention. There are a lot of flags, a lot of things to uncover, a lot of guides as well. It's not everything. This tool has a lot of functionalities. It's very basics. If you want to uncover more stuff, I have those blogs as I mentioned. So core functionality and managing AXIOM instances covers it in pretty much a lot of in depth. So feel free to check them out. So as a target, I picked up Coca-Cola VDP program. They have all in scope, since because of this brand size owned by Coca-Cola company. But for this demonstration, I will only show how you can hunt for these wildcards only. So let's head into the terminal, create the directory for the project Coca-Cola. I head into that directory. Firstly, what I like to do is to create wildcards.txt file, place this, remove stars and dots at the beginning. Well, some people are using Vim. I'm more like nano guy, So I will just remove, Control S to save and Control X to exit. And next, I would like to open the new instances. I think the 5 instances will be more than enough. For how many targets? Let's see how many wildcards we have. We have 9 wildcards. Well, I guess 5 will be pretty much okay, but also let's call them YouTube in this case. This will be the way how we can name them. And let's wait until it finishes. So the instances finished up spinning. As you can see, I have 5 instances. The first thing what I like to do is use AXIOM scan on that wildcards using subfinder module. For the output, I use O flag, and I usually like to use the tool name itself, but instead of O flag, you can also use ANew. So it basically just adds the new lines to the file, like favorite TomNomNoms tool, if you probably heard it. You can run this like this. And in parallel, you can also run another AXIOM scan for the same wildcards for a mass module as well, and add a mass output file. It will start running. To use this tool efficiently, I suggest to have more wildcards, not for 9 lines. Since I think you should use for each target at least 5, be like 25 will be more reasonable to scan on. Right now it's not very efficient, but as long as I have more targets to like hunt on, more host names, I will check if those host names resolve. So it will be more efficient. And also the AXIOM modules are located in the home directory .axiom.modules. As you can see, if I list, there are a lot of those modules. I already discussed this little bit in my blog, but I created custom module, for example, to update resolvers. Let's check this out. As you can see, I am calling this specific endpoint as it has list of resolvers, and it's updated pretty often, at least once or twice a day, and I save it to the list. It's basically for helps for other tools, for example DNSX, just to check if those collected hosts will resolve. So as you can see, I use this tool and provide the output of that. And for the modules, as you can see, there is input and output. Of course, there is different way to do it, but usually input is just splitted files for each server, and output basically what the tool will give out. And after the tool will finish, as you can see, like here, Subfinder finished in 2 minutes. MS is still running. MS is much more slower. It will merge all of those findings and send it to that file. Okay, both of those tools have finished running. Let's check how many results do we have. As you can see, there is different sets of results, but we can merge both of those outputs into one file, sort unique, and save it to the hostnames.txt. What else we can do is run AXIOM scan for those same wildcards, not hostnames, but wildcards, and use GAU module. As you can see, I have already prepared this one. It comes by default, but I added subs flag, I added blacklist just to not get all the necessary data, for example, WAF, TXT, XE files, CSS, stuff like that, and save it to the gao.txt and try to run. While GAO is running, I decided to give it another scan as well in parallel. You can, as you can do in the parallel, for the host name and use DNSX tool as well. So it basically saves time to running both of those tools in parallel. But don't overdo it. Since sometimes this could crash servers, I suggest running maybe two or three, like three tools at max. If you're using minimal VPS, don't overdo it. It actually depends on the which tools are you using. If you, for example, using DNS brute force, so you shouldn't merge with like more tools. Okay, both of those have finished running. Let's try right now run HTTPX. For HTTPX, let's check its module. Oh, it's pretty basic. I only added this one. So for AXIOM scanning, again, I want, in this case, run on DNSX output and select HTTPX module. Then you can add some extra flags, for example, silent, do not show the header, status code. I will also like to have title, maybe follow redirects, and save everything to HTTPX and run it again. Well, when the GAO finished the running, at this point I suggest you can basically just destroy your AXIOM instances, since you probably won't need them. Well, you can use them by parsing some GAO endpoints, but for that many GAO endpoints, as you can see, most of them will be filtered as well. So for example, if I check just PHP files, it won't be that many. So what I suggest at this point, just use AXIOM RM for YouTube, as it called for me. For you, it will be probably different name. And use flag to force, or use without it, just in case you are running something else on your cloud provider. You don't want accidentally to destroy your, for example, out of band server or blind XSS server. So you should use without flag. Just remove it like this. Well, as a bonus, I also promised that I will show you how you can create a custom module. So there is actually, as we discovered previously, there is modules directory located in AXIOM modules. As you can see, there is a lot of modules already included here. I created the custom ones, for example, getting GAO output and checking for SQL injections, but I also created, for example, testing for sensitive PDF files. So let's check for this, for example. As you, I told you, the input and the output will be what you will give tool. Input will be different splitted files for each server, similar lines. And as you can see, it's just a regular GAO command. I'm not using blacklist since I'm grabbing the PDF files, you have to escape this character because it's just for the module. I'm using HTTPX as well, just to get the status, and all of this is in the loop. And for each found live item for the GAU, which has PDF in it, for each result, I do curling for that endpoint, and I also use PDF to text. Basically, it just converts it to text. I have installed this in my machine, which I took the snapshot on, and I used that snapshot with this tool included for my machines. And I gripping the invoice or receipt. Alternatively, you can add another keywords, for example, internal use only, or like internal use, confidential, or stuff like that. So basically, I have created one liner, which commands I concatenate into output, and the saved output could be a result of this command. So when I run, for example, AXIOM scan, GAU targets txt, and to run this one, I use like this, you know? It has to end with JSON, and as output as well, you can use a new stuff like that. But of course, you have to check them manually. So yeah, it's the way to make your own module. I suggest for you what you can do is check HackerOne feed, check Twitter. You might find some interesting leads. From those leads, you can create your own approach, your own one-liner. Sometimes people are sharing those one-liners. So create AXIOM module and use that module with AXIOM scan. So this is very useful tip if you want to stand out from the crowd, since like everyone is doing the same recon. They are gathering subdomains, they are using wayback URLs and stuff like that, but you want to do some extra step if you want to get some, like, not bounties, but maybe get some leads that could result bounties. In this video, we learned about AXIOM's place in the Infosec community, the core features, and basic recon. As the bonus, I have shown you how it can basically be unique by including the custom module in AXIOM as one-liner command. Make sure to experiment with your own way. You might get some interesting leads. Remember that automation is just a small part of the puzzle, and the main thing is just doing it manually and checking it manually. So, if you are serious about bug bounty or just curious and learning, I just suggest you to check out my Twitter. I do post pretty useful content here. One-liners what you can include in your own modules, Google Docs, general tips and tricks, and some nice checklists. Also, if you have questions for me personally, I have a Discord channel where you can find in the description down below. Just don't be too spammy and check the rules. On the upcoming video, I think I'm going to show you my next steps of the recon, just how you can parse and analyze wayback data. If you really like this video, please smash that like button, and if you spot any mistakes or just have any suggestions, please leave the comment down below. It was really my pleasure sharing this bit of information with you. Have a nice hunt.